Hey everyone, welcome to today's video. We are going to be playing with some delicious brand new bronzers from Physicians Formula. What I have in front of me is the limited edition Cheat Day Butter Bronzers from Physicians Formula. These are so freaking adorable. I picked up three of the four shades. The one that I could not get my hands on was the Butter Cookie shade, which I was kind of bummed about. By the time I went on the Physicians Formula website, it was sold out, and I knew that that one was going to be the one to sell out because it has like this pink peachy blush shade right in the center and then the bronzer on the outside, which we all know is like a one and done type of shade. Dip your brush in that one pan and you've got your contour, your bronzer, and your blush. Boom. All in one shot. It is available as of right now. I just seen that it has been restocked and these are actually now finally available on the Ulta Beauty website. This is an exclusive, I believe, between Physicians Formula and Ulta. So the only place that you can get these, to my knowledge, is either directly from Physicians Formula or through Ulta Beauty. So check out their website first, though. I will tell you this. Before heading to an Ulta, make sure you go to their website, key in your zip code or wherever it is you want to search to make sure that the stores actually have it. So let's start with the first one. Now, my luck, and I had a feeling, I don't know why, it's like I had this premonition that one of my bronzers was going to arrive effing broken, and sure enough, one of them did, and I'm bummed because, of course, the way the world works, it was the one that I was the most excited for. It is the Butter Donut one. This one smells, oh my God, absolutely divine. It smells like mini donuts. Oh my gosh. The scent is just delicious. Not overpowering or heavy, like some people might feel about like the original butter bronzer, but it just has a perfect hint of like the cinnamon sweet, like a mini donut. Oh my God, it is absolutely divine. Now, because this one did arrive broken, I do feel like this one comes off a little bit powdery. It doesn't have like that super buttery, soft type finish like the original butter bronzer does. It feels very creamy in the pan when you swatch it, like super creamy. And it could be because it is so incredibly finely milled. I do want to show you a swatch. Now, this one is quite light. As you can see, it doesn't really show up that much against my skin tone. There definitely is a bronziness there, but not a lot. It's a pretty shade though. This one I could see myself more so contouring with. It is a bit more on the cool side, but it doesn't give me that like super punchy bronzy look. It is just a bit close to my skin tone, but it could end up being very beautiful on the skin. Now let's move on to Butter Coffee. This one smells exactly like those International House of Coffees. You remember those little tins? Oh my God, I used to drink that when I was like 10 years old. Those things are so freaking good. This smells like a hot caramel coffee. Oh my gosh, it smells so good. It almost kind of smells like gas station coffee or like the coffee that you would get like when you're staying at a hotel and you go down for your free continental breakfast. Is that weird? But that's what it smells like. Oh my God, it smells so good. Let's go ahead and swatch this one. Rubbing my finger in it, the little imprint is already gone, which is kind of a bummer. It is what it is. Now this one has way more of a sheen to it, has a little bit more of a golden undertone to it, as you can see, compared to the butter donut up here. This one has a bit more of a sheen, a little bit more golden, a little bit more bronzy. This one looks absolutely beautiful. I actually do prefer a bronzer with a bit more of a sheen. Let's move on to the last one. This one is in the shade Butter Cake. Packaging wise and the way that this looks in the pan is actually the most aesthetically pleasing to me, and I don't know why that is. It's like something about the layers in here. I was reading some reviews on this one because other than the donut one, this was the other one that I was like the most excited to try. I read that it has a lot of sheen to it and you can see that there's kind of like that almost highlight strip right there in the center, but I think that once everything kind of blends together, it's going to give you a beautiful look. Now, this one is obviously the darkest of all three. This one definitely has more of a cool undertone to it. I can definitely see that. So here you can see in contrast all of the shades. So your donut, butter donut is going to be the most cool. I think that this is going to look fantastic on more fair to light skin tones. This one right here has more of like a golden undertone, perfect for light to medium skin. This is the shade Butter Coffee in the middle. And then we have Butter Cake, which seems to be the deepest of all three. This one's going to be more for more tan, darker skin tones right here. I'm going to zoom you guys in. I'm going to try to get all three of these on my face. I'm going to be able to do it. You watch, because I want to see all of these in action so that you can make a decision if you want to pick these up or not. So I'm going to zoom you guys in. We're going to bronze up the face. We are going to start by, I want to dip into Butter Donut first, because again, this is the more fair shade. So I'm just going to pick up a little bit here of Butter Donut. I can't stop smelling this, you guys. It smells so freaking good. Not a lot of kick up. I do like to show you guys sometimes what the pigmentation looks like on the brush. And we're just going to start by tapping this on the skin. I wouldn't be surprised if this just really doesn't show up a whole lot on me. I do have a little bit of a tan right now. It's summertime. Maybe in the winter months, this might show up because I get quite fair. It smells so good as you're putting it on. It is just delicious. I want to eat it. This is actually showing up. Definitely more of a natural look. Like I said, I like this for contour. It gives me that perfect shadow that isn't too cool, isn't too warm. It is literally the perfect contour shade. I do tend to have light to medium skin with more yellow olive undertones just to kind of give you some context there. And this definitely is a really nice contour shade as I'm looking in the viewfinder and in the mirror. And it does go on quite nice. I don't see it exaggerating any texture or looking muddy or anything on the skin. I'm gonna put just a little bit here, again, just to more so contour with. I do definitely have to build this up. It is a lighter shade, but it's blending really easy. I mean, as you can see, I just have to tap it on the skin and it's pretty effortless. Let's move on to Butter Coffee. I want to use the Butter Cake last because again, like I said, it is the deepest of the three. This one does have that more golden sheen to it. Just going to stick with the same brush. Not a lot of kick up. I am bummed that that little latte feature that was in the center is now gone. You can kind of see it, but it's pretty faint. Obviously, once all the colors mix together, it kind of goes away, which is kind of shitty, but nonetheless, it's makeup. I shouldn't be buying it for the packaging or the imprint in the pan. We should be buying it for how it works, right? I'm just gonna tap this one on. I don't have any highlight on at all because I did know ahead of time that some of these did have more of a sheen to them. Oh my gosh, this one smells so good too. I am so glad that these actually smell like something other than the original butter bronzer formula. Don't get me wrong, that smells delicious, but I think it's so fun that these do have a different scent. This shade, absolutely beautiful. Now in the swatch, it looked very, very shiny finish, but on the skin, it just gives you a beautiful sheen. Absolutely stunning. This is why I always say, sometimes I don't see a point to high-end makeup. Okay, that might be a little bit controversial to say, but sometimes I really don't see it because there are so many affordable products out there that just work just as well, if not better, than some very high-end, very expensive products. I am going to come out and say that what this actually reminds me of, I'm going to dip into my powder drawer here that is so unorganized. Reminds me a lot of my Laura Geller Baked Body Frosting. This is a product that I am absolutely obsessed with, but it is a little bit more on the pricey side. So if you're looking for something very similar to this that gives you like more of that like glowy bronzy look and you don't want to spend like 40 some dollars, which I believe this bronzer costs, definitely check out Butter Coffee. This is beautiful, beautiful on the skin. All right, last but not least, let's move on to Butter Cake. Now this one is a lot deeper in tone. I'm just gonna stick with the same brush because there really isn't much product on it and I don't think it's gonna be interfering with the other shades. I'm just gonna go ahead and tap my brush in all over. This one has just a little bit more kick up, but nothing too intense. There's what it looks like on the brush. You can see instantly that there's a lot more pigment with this one and a lot more on the warmer side. Lightly tap on. This is usually how I like to put on my bronzers. I like to stipple. I don't like to do this business because I feel like it kind of disrupts my makeup underneath. This one smells so good too. That's really pretty. Definitely do not really need highlight if you use these two right here, the Butter Coffee and the Butter Cake, because they give you a sheen. I was actually a little bit worried that this was going to show up a little bit too dark on my skin, but it doesn't. I actually really, really, really like the finish. Well, now I feel like I have to go out and track down Butter Cookie because I love all of these so much that I feel like I'm going to get use out of all of them. I'm officially sold and convinced. These are beautiful. They smell delicious. The packaging is A+. They all offer something kind of different, which I absolutely love. I know that some people have always commented on the Physician's Formula range of tone, that they could definitely offer some deeper tones, which I totally definitely agree. I do feel like Physician's Formula is definitely a brand that tends to cater more towards lighter skin tones, which is unfortunate to me because their products are so fun. And I would be bummed if I saw something like this and saw all the reviews and how yummy they are and how fun they are, and then to find that one doesn't come in my shade. It is definitely a bummer. So I do wish that they would expand more on their range a bit and create some tones that are a little bit deeper. So that would be really my only feedback for this. But outside of that, I have nothing negative to say at all about these bronzers. They look absolutely beautiful on the skin. Stunning, flawless, does not exaggerate texture, gives a very airbrushed, healthy glow. Absolutely gorgeous. They nailed it with this collection. All right, so there you guys have it, the Cheat Day Limited Edition Butter Bronzers from Physician's Formula. If you are into something like this, I definitely suggest going to try at least one of these. They just work so beautifully. And I did also want to zoom out to just show you guys how it looks from afar on the skin. Gorgeous bronzers, absolutely beautiful, just as good as the butter bronzers. I have nothing negative to say. Leave me a comment down below and let me know if you picked up any of these bronzers. I would love to hear your opinions, your hot takes. I want to hear it all. Feed it to me. Give me all of your opinions in the comment section. It is my favorite part of posting a video, to be honest with you guys. I love hearing your feedback. And I also want to know what you guys think about this product on me. Which one did you like the best? Did finally seeing these in action change your mind? Is there a shade in particular that you now have your eye on and you've got your radar on it and you're like, ooh, I need to go pick that up? If you enjoyed this video, please do me a solid and hit that thumbs up. That way I know that you are enjoying the content and you want to see more videos just like this. If you haven't already, it is your first time here. Welcome. I would be absolutely tickled if you would hit the subscribe button. Make sure you hit the bell button and choose all. That way you actually get notifications when I upload videos just like this one. I want to thank you guys so much for watching today, and I look forward, as always, to seeing you in the next video. Mwah. Bye, guys.